Little Eva Mitchell is one of our country's sickest kids. She can't eat, can't breathe for long without oxygen. In fact, she can barely leave the sight of her doctors and nurses. The four-year-old has lived in Starship Hospital since the day she was born. But as sick as she is, she's also happy and very, very cute. She cracks jokes and loves her life as she knows it. Mum Tiffany won't leave Eva's side, so that's meant not walking through the front door of her own home for over 2 years. Together with Dad Joel and older sister Mila, they're an inspirational family who look for the best in the worst situations. Here's Hannah Ockleford with the Mitchells.
In so many ways, Eva Mitchell is a normal four-year-old. On the outside, anyway.
Gonna clean around your line.
But this mess of tubes and lines feed inside her small body, simply to keep her alive.
You can have the blue one.
The blue one, thank you.
Do you like blue?
I like blue.
People say to me, oh, you must be heartbroken that your child's so sick.
Mum?
My heart's definitely got cuts and scratches and cracks in it, but there's no way it's heartbroken because there's a hell of a lot of space in there for all this love that this little girl gives.
You're not going to squirt me?
No.
Is that your secret weapon?
Shh, don't tell anyone. Don't tell anyone.
I will tell Mum.
Will you?
When Tiffany was pregnant, her and her husband were told their baby wouldn't survive and they were given the choice to abort.
There wasn't really a choice because I could feel the baby moving, you know. I'd been talking to it.
Against all odds, Eva was born alive. But the entire left side of her diaphragm was missing, and her heart, intestines and liver had moved into its space. Her lungs were left seriously underdeveloped.
She was induced at full term, and that's the twist, was that she came out and they finally, after a big battle, managed to stabilise her and get her into intensive care.
She is a miracle, a very sick little miracle.
Oh, hell yeah. yeah, that's, she's a miracle. She is an absolute miracle.
See, my hands are cold, darling.
14.5. Are you kidding me?
Hang on, wait. Tube Eva, as she's known around here, needs constant medical attention and is almost permanently hooked up to this pole.
She goes from anywhere from 20 hours on it to 24 hours on it. So it's part of her, her pole is part of her.
Can Eva eat real food?
She can nibble and suck really real food, but if it gets into her stomach, it just sits there till we have to somehow get it out.
Mummy.
Yeah, hang on, I'm just getting out. Will she ever be able to eat real food? I have asked the doctors that and nobody can say.
Doing the best cuddles.
The sterile walls of Ward 25B have become very familiar. Eva's lived in Starship Children's Hospital since the day she was born.
Can you stay with me up?
Now, I often do say, how much longer can a child live in hospital? You know, how much longer can you do this for? Well, you do it for as long as your child needs it, I guess. So,
how's your baby girl? Good?
But Tiffany and her husband Joel have two children. Mila is Eva's perfectly healthy six-year-old sister.
I know things are horrible for Eva and they're hard, but my heart probably breaks a little bit more for Mila at times because she's old enough to know what it should be, and she's the one that misses out that little bit more on the normal existence because she knows what normal is.
And who do you play with?
Eva.
All the time? Is she your favourite friend?
Apart from all the nurses, eh?
Yeah. She lives in this really stressful environment. There's alarms going off. She can't go anywhere without someone with her because, you know, you don't know who's safe and who's not, and, you know.
It seems there are a few options when your sister's sick, but to stay by her side.
Is your toast still hot, Mia?
Mine is warm. Is yours?
Hot.
What, five-year-old, six-year-old? Eats her breakfast, you know, in a hospital corridor, which six-year-old is in bed at 8:30 at night, you know, if she's lucky at that, and then dragged up to the hospital at 11 o'clock at night. It's not fair on her, but what is fair on her is that she gets to cry up with her mum and her sister and her dad. Okay, you can help me.
Do you sometimes ask, why me?
I've probably stopped asking why quite so much. Now I'm at the point I can say, you know, how lucky am I? I'm lucky. I'm lucky to have these two little girls. quite often late at night, I've got a blog on Eva's Facebook and I write in that, and that's probably when I have a big distress and a cry while I write it and let everything out.
It's 11 p.m. and every night at this time, Eva vomits after having routine treatment.
Oh yeah, I'll be right up. Okay, see ya.
And so every night, Tiffany bundles up Mila to take the 5-minute walk from Ronald McDonald House, where they live, toward 25B, where Eva lives. Whatever the weather. The same thing repeatedly, each time Mila's in tow. Until the new dawn.
Eva is usually awake around 5. Today it was 4.
Do you get much sleep?
No. No. I know. I'm completely nuts. Sleep deprived and nuts. So, yeah. No, sleep's the one thing I'm kind of missing.
Eva, you're so lucky.
When just surviving is so unlikely, a fourth birthday is cause to party. With family and friends nearby and far away.
But we just want to say, Eva, happy birthday.
Each year, Eva celebrates in her home, the ward.
There might not be another birthday next year. We're realistic, so yeah, her birthdays are huge, and it goes on for days and days.
It's not a regular family life. While Tiffany takes care of both girls during the week, husband Joel's working in their hometown Warkworth, joining them for weekends.
How are you?
Dad, you done
it. I did.
And I'd say, yeah, he grieves every day for her, worries every day. That's his little girl, and he loves her more than anything. He'll be down when she's really sick and see her and, you know, see her in intensive care. But when she's well enough to leave, he gets sent off to work. Give Dad a kiss!
While the girls miss out on having him round, so does his wife.
It's been pretty rough at times, so I'm going to be really honest. It's been pretty hideous.
With Joel and the Mitchells' extended family all out of town, Tiffany's had to improvise.
We adopt family wherever we go. Ronald McDonald House, the staff there are our family. My little girls have a whole heap of nanas and aunties are there.
What's that? Are you kind of like a grandma to the girls? Well,
yeah, she's my nan.
Kate Mead works at Ronald McDonald House and is one of the Mitchells' adopted family.
Oh, it's a postcard for Eva from one of her nurses.
I have all these ladies that tell me exactly, you know, what I should do. You know, tell me my skirt's too short. You know, all the motherly things. So, yeah.
It's not just about hemlines. Tiffany swears by always dressing up.
Why do I do it? I think because it's probably part of being in control of this whole thing. And I think if you wake up in the morning and you tidy yourself up and you dress up, then you're in control for the day. I have complete days where I look a complete fright, though, absolutely. So I'm actually way more gorgeous than I look today.
Eva, I've got a question for you.
What?
Can you pop over here?
There is no patient quite like Eva Mitchell.
Is it correct that no one's found a medical expert in the world that can help her?
Short answer is yes.
Paediatrician Greg Williams is Eva's lead doctor.
And a big guy.
And has watched her grow up.
Is it really sore, Eva? What if we get some remove? Thank you. There have been plenty of times when I've taken my work home with me and not been able to sort of kind of let it go a little bit.
Stinging it.
Right now, his goal for Eva is short trips out of hospital.
But I don't think any of us have a real feel for just what it'd be like. We get to go home each day. These guys have just been, it's like being on home detention. They're just stuck there.
Oh, if
that's leaking.
Excuse me, please.
Will you know when the time comes to stop trying?
Ask myself. I talk about it with Eva's parents from time to time.
Should we go to our house?
Yep, in a minute.
And we're all in agreement that what we're doing still seems the right thing to do for Eva.
Hi, Greg.
Hi, Eva.
I ask all the time, you know, how much longer do you think this would go on for? It goes on while Eva fights, and she's fighting now. And, you know, ultimately, where you live or what you do or anything like that is irrelevant when it comes to your child's health.
What you did today?
Aww. One more sleep.
So for today and tomorrow and every day, Tiffany and her girls will keep living their private lives in the public hospital.
My children are normal in the fact that they are going to scream, they're going to have tantrums, they're going to fight. Yeah, I'm parenting and doing it in front of all these eyes, and some days you do get really, really sick of it.
Finish flash.
Flash. Finish.
Now which one?
Melatonin.
Why? Not melatonin yet.
No. I can't do it that way.
You can't help but, you know, just love her. But it's hard seeing her when she's in that pain or, you know, vomiting or really struggling.
Hi, Mum.
You're not feeling very well today, eh?
That's the tough thing about little Eva. She can be so well one minute.
Feeling cold.
Then life-threateningly ill the next.
Eva is a really, really, really sick little girl that probably sometimes I don't even realise how sick she is. I've had moments where she's been really well and I've taken her to school and I've had her at Ronald McDonald House and then taken her up to the hospital and been taken to intensive care.
What are your hopes for Eva's future?
For Eva? Right now, what do I want for my children for the future? I want them to live and be happy, to just make the most of their life.
Does she have a good chance of getting through this?
If she keeps going the way she's going with her fight, she will have a few good years in her. But I think as a mum and a human being, I can look at this and say the chances probably aren't great. Eva's facing this journey. We're doing this journey, so you do it all together and you fight it and make it happen.
Simple things mean success in this unconventional household.
Mela, look, here's some grass, carpet.
Simple things like smiles every day.
What does that say?
You know, you've got to take each day as it is because, you know, you don't know what's going to happen tomorrow. So I owe that to Eva. I can't fix Eva and I can't really change this, but I can make this as good for her as possible.
For Eva, freedom's being off the pole. And honing skills that come naturally when you've lived your whole life in a hospital ward.
Does this help to clean my finger?
It
can't. Is it?
My little girl's story is not a sad story. It's a story that's telling you, you know, take your life. It's precious.
Do his head.
Oh.
He's his head. What do you say? Ready,
set, go.
Do you ever regret the decision you made to keep Eva?
No. No, I can honestly say I don't.
Set, go.
If Eva was sickly and laying in bed and miserable, I'm sure I would question myself that all the time. But she's not. She's not. And Eva loves her life.
Should we do it orange?
Okay. And actually what I've learned through Eva is so massive that, yeah. I wouldn't take it back for a second.
It made the whole smile.
Oh, Eva, you are awesome, and your mum seems pretty cool as well. What an incredible family. We'll put a link up to Cure Kids on our Facebook page. That's 2020 New Zealand. Check it out, because as you'll see, our reporter Hannah and Tiffany have got a mission to complete, and they may need your help. You can also leave a message for the Mitchells if you fancy. I'm sure they'd love to hear from you.